Hello YouTube, this is the Comic Book Minimalist, and it's a pleasure to finally join the YouTube comic book community. I've been enjoying comic book based YouTube videos for about 2 years, and it is because of all of you passionate and enthusiastic collectors that I am here today starting my channel and showing off my collection. So for that I thank you. You may ask, why call yourself the comic book minimalist? Well, two words, condo living. Condo living does not afford me much storage space, so I have to be disciplined in what I purchase to keep my collection manageable. I collect modern comic books. I'm also a reader. But I do not buy reader copies. I read all my books digitally. So here I have a selection of books that I picked up recently. We'll start with Harley Quinn 25th Anniversary Special number 1. This is Jim Lee cover. Jim Lee is one of my favorite artists. And this is a beautiful Harley Quinn cover. Jean Grey number 4, this is the Jim Lee trading card variant. Dynamic Jean Grey going full Phoenix cover. This is Uncanny X-Force number 1. This is from the 2010 series, J. Scott Campbell cover. There's also a Comic-Con variant, which says New York City Comic Con 2010 down here, but it's basically the same image. Uncanny X-Force number 1, this is the Premier Edition variant. This is the artist is Esad Ribic. And if you didn't get a chance to read this run, this is a very interesting story. Very well written by Rick Remender, and the interior art is by Jerome Pena. So it's a really good read. I have A-Force number 1. This is the Adam Hughes variant, celebrating 50 years of the Inhumans with Medusa on the cover. This particular cover is a 1 in 50 variant. If you don't know what that ratio means, that means that retailers had to purchase 50 copies of A-Force number 1, the regular cover, in order to qualify to purchase one of these Adam Hughes covers. So basically that's what the variant ratio is. Future Imperfect number 3. This is a Mike Diodato cover of the Maestro, and I just love this cover. I mean, Diodato is a fantastic artist, and this is just one of my favorite Maestro covers. Future Imperfect number 1, this is the Gwen Stacy variant in 2015. Marvel put out a bunch of Gwen Stacy variants in their various titles. This one obviously is Gwen Stacy as the Hulk. This cover is by Nick Bradshaw. If you see the transformation, by the time she gets to here, you know, the belts, I mean, I love the detail on this cover, the belts flying, everything's flying, but if you could see here, basically the clothing's gone. So if we were to continue the transformation up, the top would be gone and she would be nude, which is what you would expect if you go from this size to this size. You know, the fucking clothes are gonna go. But I love how it was detailed here on this cover. Now, probably the most popular of the Gwen Stacy covers is Deadpool's Secret Wars number 2, which is a Chris Pachalo cover, and this is the first ever appearance of Gwenpool. He created the character. If he didn't make this cover, there would be no Gwenpool. It was because of the popularity of this cover and the fact that cosplayers really started to dress as her, that Marvel decided to actually give her an ongoing series. So basically this is the cover that started it all. I still think it's the best rendering of Gwenpool. I mean, she looks amazing. Her first appearance was in Howard the Duck number 1. This particular series was written by Chip Zdarsky, but the part that she's in is written by Christopher Hastings, who would go on to write her ongoing series. This is the 1 in 50 variant. The cover artist is David Aja, and this definitely is, if you're a Gwenpool fan, this is an important book to have. This is Ms. Marvel number 1 from 1977. This is Carol Danvers' first appearance as Ms. Marvel. This is a John Romita Sr. cover. Again, with Carol Danvers now Captain Marvel, and getting her own movie, this is, you know, a good book to have. This is a commissioned art piece that I had done by a local artist. This is Captain Marvel number 1, a blank variant that I had the artist do Carol Danvers as Captain Marvel. I know the hair is different, but that's how I told the artist I wanted him to do it. But I mean, it's just amazing. I mean, the guy did a fantastic job. The uniform looks amazing. Got the smoke coming off the hand from, you know, a recent energy blast. It's just a beautiful cover. And the last book I'm gonna show you is Superman and Chain number 1. This is the 2013 miniseries of 6 issues, celebrating the 75 years of Superman. This story was written by Scott Snyder, and the art was done by Jim Lee. This is a Jim Lee cover. This is a 1 in 300 variant, which again means that a retailer had to purchase 300 of cover A, the regular cover, in order to qualify to purchase one of this cover. And to this date is probably one of my favorite Superman covers of all time. It's just flawless for me, in my opinion. If you haven't read the book, basically what's going on here is he's ripping open a piece of a space station that's falling out of the sky to save the astronauts inside. So this is all pieces of debris from the space station that he's tearing apart. And I mean, the detail on this cover is just fantastic. And you'll see a lot of these. I love the sketch variants, the black and white variants. It's almost like the artist, you know, did a commission for you. At least that's the way I see it. But that's it for my first showcase. If you like this video, if you think you might like the content in this channel, please subscribe. And I hope to post maybe a few times a week. So thank you for your time and have a good day.